If you, like me, own an R36S or R36H handheld console, then this video is going to be super useful for you. As you probably know, this console has been around for quite a while, and over that time, the manufacturers have used several different types of screens. I talked about this in one of my previous reviews of the R36S with a panel 4 screen. Back then, if you wanted to install ArkOS, you had to download a specific version of the firmware based on your screen type, which wasn't the most convenient process. But now things have changed. A new version of ArkOS was released recently and it's now universal, meaning it works with all screen types. You just download one version of ArkOS and during installation, you hold a specific button combo that matches your screen version. That's it. Sounds a little confusing? Don't worry, I'll walk you through everything step by step. First, we need to find out which screen version is installed on your console. To do that, I remove the default SD card with the stock firmware and plug it into my computer. Then I go to a special website that helps identify your screen version. You'll find the link to this site in the description box. Make sure to read the instructions carefully. You'll need to upload a file with one of these names. On the SD card, in the boot section, I choose this specific file and then click the Identify my screen button. As you can see, I have the original screen. In your case, it might say Panel 4 or something else entirely. Important note, if you don't see these files in the boot section or if the boot partition is missing altogether, chances are you have a clone. I recommend checking your console against the key differences between the original and clones. I've linked a page in the description box that will help you figure that out. And before we continue, please like and subscribe to the channel and leave a comment. This helps me promote the channel. Also, you can click the bell icon so you don't miss any new videos. Thank you for your attention. Let's continue. So, once you know which screen version you have, it's time to download the ArkOS firmware. Choose whichever download source is easiest for you. Next, we need to install the firmware onto a new high-quality SD card. I always recommend replacing the stock SD cards as soon as possible. They're low quality and can fail without warning. I've included a table with recommended SD cards, links in the description as well. I've already shown how to flash the firmware in previous videos, whether you're using a Mac, Windows, or even an Android device. You'll find separate videos for each platform in the description box. The process is pretty simple no matter which OS or device you're using. First, unzip the archive we just downloaded. Then use a flashing tool to write the image onto your new SD card. I usually use Etcher app on both Mac and Windows. It's free and super easy to use. But if you're not very tech savvy or this is your first time doing it, make sure to follow one of my step-by-step videos. Once flashing is done, I eject the SD card from my Mac and insert it into the first slot on the console, the one for the operating system. I leave the second slot for game storage empty for now. Now here's the new part. Based on the new ArkOS instructions, right after powering on the console, I need to hold R1 and A buttons. That's the combo for the original screen. In your case, it might be a different combo, like X or one of the D-pad directions, left, right, up or down. I hold the combo until the console shuts down. Then I turn the console on again. And we see the ArkOS splash screen and the setup process starts. Once the setup is complete and you're on the main screen, go to Options, then to Device Type and choose your console. In my case, it's R35S or R36S. Confirm by pressing A. That's it, all the main settings are now in place, and the console is ready to go. As you can see, the installation process hasn't changed much, but now it's way more convenient and universal. No more hunting down specific firmware versions for different screens. I am honestly so happy to see ArkOS evolving like this. It's making my experience with the R36S even better. All the links you need are in the description box. And don't forget to subscribe to my Telegram channel, I post a lot of useful and interesting stuff there too. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please like and subscribe to the channel. I wish you pleasant nostalgia and successful completion of your favorite games.